I think about who they could have been and what they would have been like. And so, yeah, those were our future children.
Future children that are now gone. Kate Plants and the others we spoke with stored their frozen eggs and embryos at university hospitals in Cleveland.
So you trusted that your eggs, your embryos would be safe at the hospital here in Cleveland?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
You never imagined this would happen?
No, not at all.
The eggs and embryos were stored in a freezer tank at university hospitals, which was equipped with a remote alarm system that should have alerted an employee to any temperature change. But the hospital says the alarm was off, so an alert was never issued. And the lab wasn't staffed Saturday night, so the temperature in the tank continued to rise, causing the embryos to thaw.
We take full responsibility for what has happened. We are very sorry that this happened. This is a catastrophic event for patients.
Problems filling the tank with liquid nitrogen may have thrown off the temperature. University Hospital says at least 4,000 eggs and embryos were lost, impacting 950 patients.
What did you lose that day?
I lost my reason for being alive, really. Starting a family was really kind of all I had as far as a purpose.
Now I'm never going to know what those babies are going to grow up to be or anything.
That's what I lost. It's just like the hope for my future and not knowing like if I'm going to be able to now have kids.
To preserve the opportunity to have a child.
Attorney Jack Landskroner is suing University Hospitals on behalf of about 180 families he represents. An investigation for the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services found that the very same storage tank experienced a malfunction in the filling mechanism and remote alarm system back in January. The tank's manufacturer denies its equipment malfunctioned.
The hospital then neglected to take the necessary steps to repair the concerns that were raised months before this incident ever occurred.
Nor did they make your clients, their patients, aware of this.
They made no disclosure to the clients who had eggs and embryos stored at this facility that they were having problems and a pattern of malfunctions.
If the hospital has already admitted wrongdoing, why the lawsuit?
Well, I think our clients want answers, and they really haven't gotten them yet. We're suing for what the law allows, which is for compensation for our clients for what they've lost, and also, ideally, to have changes made that will allow these systems to be safer.
University Hospitals declined our request for an interview, citing pending litigation. But in an email, they told us that patients are their first priority, and they're working to improve operations at the fertility clinic. Still, that won't help these families. They lost all their eggs and embryos and can hardly think about the painful process of going through IVF again. For some, that's not even an option.
So that was our only chance to have biological kids because both of my cancers were estrogen-based, and so to pump me with more hormones to get more embryos is out of the question.